Hey everyone, in this video I'd like to show you how I get inspired and start creating my nature scenes in Blender. So I often starting this by searching some images inside Pinterest. So here I just type Big Cliff Landscape Fantasy. So right now I'm really into big landscape and fantasy stuff. So most of the time what I do is like maybe I like this one. And so I'm using pure ref here, and what you can do with pure ref is just you can just click and drag the image you like, and then it imported in the soft, so you can create mood board with it. So I really like this one, so I will put the link in description if you want to download it. So next, what I'd like to do is to feed one or more images that I like inside Midjourney to create a variant. So to do that, you can upload a file here and select the image you want. So let's upload this one. You click on it and you can open it inside your navigator. You copy the link here and then go back to Midjourney/imagine. Then you paste the link of your image, and don't forget to type another prompt or it won't work. So maybe landscape. Hit enter. So as you can see, the generation is done, and the results are now quite good with Midjourney. The new version is really, really good. And so what you can do is upscale the one you like, or maybe make some other variation. Like you can maybe choose the first one and make a variation out of it. Or you can reroll the entire generation if you wish. But anyway, for my latest animation, I was really inspired by this image. So what I like to do is at first trying to recreate the sense of scale that I got here inside Blender. So here you can see that I got some cliff assets that I'm bash them so it can create some variation. I'm placing my camera at the right angle, and then creating as well my floor with a flat shape. And then after that, I'm subdividing my floor so I can sculpt it. So I begin with a big radius so I can do the rough detail, and then I will decrease this radius to do those smaller details. And then I like to add my water shader here, so I can see where is my water will be, and I can integrate it better with the soil and my rocks. So the idea with the assets, with my sculpting floor and the water, is them to be integrated the right way. So I'm always changing the place of my asset, changing the place of my camera, sculpting a bit here, a bit there, so everything is integrated the best I can. So here I'm adding a tree that will really set up the scale of the entire scene. So this is the most important thing, at least for me at the beginning when I'm starting doing my scene inside Blender, is to have these scales by placing all the big element assets, and then adding maybe a character or here a tree that can set up this scale, so you can see the difference between a small element and the biggest element of your scene. So that's it. After, once you have done with the block out of your scene, you can really start adding nature stuff like grass, other trees, and then smaller details. So thanks for watching this video, and see you in the next one.